Yeah, hello to the next part of the eye tracking walkthrough video. In this part, I want to particularly focus on running the study in the player, so how the participant will do an eye tracking study. And yeah, for this, first of all, I want to make the study a bit more interesting. So what I will do here, I will make this very simple. I will just insert here two images, like think of it like a two alternative forced choice task. Yeah, and so I insert here two images. I will, yeah. Let's say do three trials, so I'll include three images for each of these placeholders. So three images for this one. So these are just like images, face images, and then I will do the same for the other image here. Maybe choose some other images. This is a bit random here, but serves a purpose. Okay. And yeah, I will also make the background color black just because then this looks a bit nicer. And I will also create an event just to go to the next trial. So let's say call this event choice. And the user can click on one of the two targets. And when that happens, let's say I want to record on which target they clicked. So I do that. And then I just go to the next trial. So it's very simple. I also record the gaze data, as we already did in the previous video, and that's kind of it. Importantly, I also changed the background color here to black, and what is important is that the background color here should match the background color in the overall task, because the background color and the overall task is also the background color used for the calibration, the eye tracking calibration. And it is important because we're using here an RGB camera for eye tracking that basically the background color in the calibration is the same as in the eye tracking task, in this case, black. It can lead to some strange effects if the color diverges a lot. So this is just one more thing to think about. Yeah, we can look at the settings here again, but this looks all good. So we can give this a go. I activate the data recording so that we actually record data. And then I just try. So as you can see here, there will be actually an initial short time before the study starts where the participant sees him or herself in the faces overlaid with this mesh, and this is actually done before the study starts so that the subject can see and evaluate whether this actually works well. Because if this does not work well, because maybe the computer is not really good enough to process this quickly enough, or there are some other issues, then the participant can indicate that, and he doesn't even need to start the study, and then thereby again the dropout rate later will be much lower. So, but for me, this works, you know, very nicely. I can move my head. This is, you know, matching my face very well. So I'm saying yes. So now I can start the study. It's a very simple study. So now I'm doing the eye tracking calibration. For the eye tracking calibration, you can change all the text that is appearing here. Of course, we have some text that you can use. But you can change all of that. You can also translate all of that. In general, all the text, all this static text, so to say, that we show here, is also automatically translated into 9 languages. So there's a lot of freedom here you can do. But some things that we just, of course, like to mention is, of course, in general, when you do an experiment, you should be in a quiet room, maybe by yourself, have enough time. And then for eye tracking in particular, you should not really wear glasses. It can work sometimes, but especially if the glasses are very reflective, it's not a good idea. And also your webcam should be kind of in the center of the screen and not have a strange angle. Next thing. So the other thing that's important is there should be not a really bright light source in the back, kind of into the camera, because this kind of over flares the whole screen and or the whole scenery, and then this would be hard for our algorithm to predict the eye position very well. And yeah, it's of course nice if the eye is illuminated from the front, so that So now comes the calibration. So the calibration, during the calibration, the subject is asked to move the head into different head poses, and we do then one round of calibration for each head pose. So let's say a head pose could be front on, or like moving the head to the left or to the right. And this will help our algorithm basically train individually for each subject. So to say, while the subject is being in different head orientations, and this can later on then be used if the subject is moving the head to predict the position of the eye, because it's very important how the head is oriented. That's one thing, and the other thing again is this virtual chin rest, what we call it. This is this green mask here. So the blue mask overlays my face, and the green mask is kind of where my face should be in 3D. And so if I press here continue and say, because this is the head pose that I want to keep for the rest of the study, and then I'm moving out, then I will actually be asked to realign to this pose. So now comes the calibration, and this is now in black, as you can see, because my main task is also in black, and I'm fixating now these red circles, or actually ideally the gray small dot inside of it. So now I'm asked to move my head to the left. I'm asked to move my head to the right. You can see this can sometimes be a bit tricky, but usually after moving around for a few seconds, you can get this pose, and then just again focus on the gray points here. So overall, basically, the calibration can take, depending on what type of calibration you choose, between 1 and 5 minutes. This was maybe roughly three minutes or so. Now actually the task starts, and before the trial there's always this recalibration, so it's three short points. And now I see two faces, I look on them, and I can actually maybe click on one of them, and then there's another recalibration. Again, I can look around. And yes, then finally I can do this again. And yeah, then we are done with this. Yeah, the next part of the video will basically be about the data output and how we can use it. Thank you for watching.